right, here I am, Dr. Clint Rogers. I guess you can probably see where we are in Paris with Dr. Naram, the famous Dr. Naram.
Yes. Hello, hello.
And Dr. Giovanni from Italy.
Hello.
Yes. All right, so we just got done with actually 2 days of clinic where almost 100 people came per day for the time period that we're there, and really saw some fascinating, interesting things. So this tele-seminar series is about radical resourcefulness. And, you know, one of the people that is a good friend to me, he said to me, you know, Clint, your biggest problem? I said, what? And he's like, your biggest problem is you think that life shouldn't have any problems. And I started to think about that more, and he says, who do you know that doesn't have any problems? He's like, your problems are actually your gifts, because it's through your problems that you grow. And one of the people who I've learned about this that changed my perception towards problems is actually Dr. Naram. He told me that when you encounter a problem, you should get excited about it. He keeps a problem journal where, you know, some of the people that I interviewed yesterday, a couple of people had cancer that went away. One woman I interviewed today, she had lost her period for 6 years. Thanks to his treatment, she has period again. One woman yesterday was 52 years old, had a baby for the first time. She came to Dr. Naram and asked if he could prolong her menopause. And he says, okay, sure. So he did that. She has a baby, a beautiful baby girl that's 1.5 years old. I'm like, he sees these problems that people think are insurmountable, but he's so resourceful in finding solutions. So I just wanted him to share some tip or some idea for you about how he does that. So, Dr. Naram?
Yeah. First of all, namaskar, everybody. I love you all who is listening me. One day, somebody came to my master. This is 30 years ago when he was 115 years old, and said that how can we have no problems in our life? I will be only happy if there is no problem. So my master took him to one place and he said, see, here are the people lying, they have no problems. And believe me, I was so shocked. It was a cemetery of dead people. He says, if you have only no problems when you are dead. If you are alive, then you don't have problems, you have challenges. So important is how to see any problem or any concern into challenges. And we all have challenges. More challenges you take, the bigger challenges you take, the bigger you become an achiever. I have not seen any problem on this planet which has no solution. Now the question is, do we have an eye to see a solution? If there is a challenge, then there is a solution. Then there can be options of solutions. So when we get a problem, or we think that this is a problem, your mind stops, your right brain stops, and your left brain sees as if you are feeling stuck. I have seen such amazing solution coming out of people who had such big problems which you cannot even imagine. I have many patients coming from more than 108 countries suffering from chronic and acute health challenges like diabetes, blood pressure, arthritis, osteoporosis, kidney problem. I had a person who was diagnosed as chronic renal failure. The creatinine was more than 11.5, and the doctor said, you have to go for dialysis instantly. Now this man, his name is James, comes to me in Germany and he says, I am having the biggest problem on this planet and my kidneys are stuck and now I don't know what to do. And I have to go for dialysis, but I don't want to go for dialysis. Is there something in your ancient secrets? And believe it or not, this is 9 years ago. Today, his creatinine is 2. He is living very healthily, very happily. So, I have seen people in my life. There are boys and girls who are either mentally retarded or having autism or no focus, and the parents are stuck that this is a problem which has no solution. Yes, in some pathy there is no solution, but if some box is closed, you start looking at other possibilities. So once you go from challenge to solution to seeing a possibility, then maybe you do not have an answer, somebody else has an answer. So first is to recognize a challenge, number one. Number two, what is possible solution? Or what are the other different possibilities on this planet which have solved this problem? Or for them, this is not a problem. Maybe you think it is a problem, but for other people, may not be a problem. So look for a way out. If you look for a way, you will see the way. But first is you have to reframe your life, seeing things as a possible, and then look for possibility. And believe me, after helping more than 1 million people from 108 countries, I have come to a very powerful conclusion that there is a possibility. And once you see possibility, then you will see also many, many options. One is fast option, one is medium options, one is long-term options, but there are options available. Today, we get stuck. I have a diabetes. Now I have to take this medication for lifetime. And then I am a candidate for stroke, I am a candidate for heart problem, I am a candidate of kidney failure. Yes, you are, if you believe that way. But if there is an option, there are possibilities. In ancient secrets, in my own life, I had diabetes. My father had diabetes. My three uncle died with diabetes, with lot of chronic side effects of medication like kidney failure, stroke and whatnot. And I also got. But then, what are the solutions? So I started finding solution from these ancient secrets, and believe it or not, I had a blood sugar which was 485. Today, I have a blood sugar which is 96 with eating ice creams in Italy. And today I'm in France. I'm going to eat some French bread, French cheese, and I'm going to take care by pressing right murmur, taking some right herbal supplements, following certain principles. And I believe I can be free from diabetes. There are thousands and millions of people who had no jobs, got jobs. They could not even speak, they started speaking. People who could not see, they started seeing. So I believe there is no problem which has no solution. There is only challenges. Now the question is, are you ready to do proper homework? Are you ready to see for the options? Are you ready to expand your consciousness to see possibilities? Then there are thousands and thousands of possibilities for any challenges. I give you one example. I was working in one country. And they said, and it was Switzerland, they said, you cannot work. You need to be a doctor. Believe it or not, I got a very special permission to work in Switzerland. I go all over the world and I say, how things can be possible? What are possibilities? What are options available? Maybe one road is closed, but there are many windows which are open. Look into that windows, find out the way, and start living your life successfully. I love you all. I respect you all. Only one thing. Look for possibilities. Don't look for problems. If you look for problems, there are many, many problems. And if you look for possibilities, there are double solutions than what you can ever imagine in your life. Namaskar.
Okay, thank you, Dr. Naram. You know, for a lot of you, it's not about health, and it is about health. But whether it's your health, your business, your personal life, your relationships, how do you get to the point that you can take problems and change them into opportunities? So people fly from all over the world to see Dr. Naram. For their health, yeah, but really it's because when they're in front of him, he's able to take something that seems impossible and make it possible. So how do you do that? How do you become that kind of a person that people seek after you for that skill? That you can, and part of it's changing the questions that you're asking, part of it's changing the mentality, part of it's working on a team, Part of it's thinking of alternative solutions maybe other people wouldn't think of. We're going to talk about it on this call. I'm excited about this, and maybe even having Dr. Naram on the call with us, but having you on the call and together doing some resourceful, radically resourceful thinking. Some resourceful thinking, some resourceful thinking. Oh yeah, I forgot to mention, we're in front of the Arc de Triomphe right now. So I just want this to be a symbol of your triumph moment. That, you know, we want to stretch you outside of your comfort zone, so you take some problem that you think is a problem, go outside of your comfort zone, change it into an opportunity, and that will be your Arc de Triomphe moment. It's not about how much money you have. Lots of people who are millionaires and billionaires come to Dr. Naram. Their money doesn't solve their problem. They're looking for someone who has options that help them shed light on the situation so the impossible becomes possible. How do you do that? What if you become so powerful in looking at a problem, changing, just reframing it so that you become a walking possibility maker, that the resourcefulness in you, the resourcefulness transforms not only you, but all the people that you're around so that they seek after you for that ability to change that impossible into possible. There's your Arc de Triomphe.